Less than 10 minutes to go before the jumps to an end. Devin Choksi of KR Choksi Securities is with us. Devin, hi, good afternoon. It's been a terrific move on the upside. But what are the top stocks that you would recommend investors buy into now? Should one stick to the market leaders in banks and autos, etc., or are you looking at mid-caps now?
Yeah, good afternoon. Well, I think the important elements of the entire market rally is a good amount of liquidity which has started coming in. And as a result of which, those who were sitting on shore, they also started putting in the money. So it has basically combined this entire thing. And probably one could argue that this could be the election, pre-election rally also. Given the kind of a situation in which we are, probably I think I would say with select quality stocks and fundamentals would be the preference. Likes of Reliance, likes of private banks, corporate banks like ICICI, Kotak, I think they remain in the preference list. Even I think the auto companies like Ashok Leyland and Tata Motors, they remain in preference list. So we remain selective about I think this entire business as far as I think the pre-election rally is concerned. Believe that I think liquidity is definitely here to stay for some time. But at the same time, I think one would like to stay with quality businesses and not chase, I think, the valuations elsewhere. So probably, I think, some of the large cap companies would mean a significant opportunity. In the mid cap basket too, I think you have some select opportunities, but I think they are very, very selective. The way in which I think some of the mid cap stocks have started rallying in last few days, once again, I think one would like to be careful in putting the bets and selecting the stock into the portfolio.
Okay. Devin, hi. Good afternoon. I wanted your thoughts on Bharti Airtel. It's up 5% as we speak today. You think one of those rallies which flatter to deceive, or is this time looking a bit different?
Yep. Good afternoon, Anuj. Obviously, I think the balance sheet repairing exercise, as we call it as, I think is on, wherein the capital infusion is taking place from the promoters and the investors into the company. I think so that will certainly mean good thing for Bharti. But on the other side, when I see how they are going to utilize the fund, I probably get little sense that I think it is not going to produce results in hurry. Which means that I think on one side you are capitalizing the balance sheet, and the other side you will be spending money for building the infrastructure, which would be tower to fiber infrastructure, which the company will be putting more efforts on. And given the kind of I think investment that they would be doing in next 2 years' time, I would think that I think for next 2 years the company would still continue to remain in the capex mode. There would be some improvement into the revenue propositions because of some tweaking on the revenue side as far as I think the product plans are concerned. But my viewpoint is that I think the fundamentals of the companies could probably take a little longer time to change. And as a result of which, I think you would probably end up giving larger amount of market to a company like Jio, where they are positioned very well because of the capex program complete, and I think they are right now integrating all other networks into one, and probably I think rolling out I think the Jio version 2 at this point of time. So from that perspective, I think the preference will go to Jio. Maybe I think more amount of business could be talked about from that area. Bharti will certainly I think take some time in my viewpoint, I think, as far as improvement in the business, the fundamentals are concerned.
Okay, we'll come back to you for some more calls, Devin. For now, we just need to get some market opinion as well. Arvind Sanger of Geosphere Capital spoke to us earlier in the day. He said that the political fears on the lines of plausible formation of weak coalition in the upcoming general elections have somewhat receded, and FIs are now getting a bit more comfortable about the Indian markets. Listen in.
The Indian economic growth cycle is stronger than any political party from a long-term standpoint. But one of our hopes and expectations would be that if the current ruling party and in a coalition or on its own comes back, the government comes prepared with a stronger, clearer idea of what they want to do early after election. If you get a new coalition of a lot of different parties, we don't know how long it'll take them to formulate a cohesive strategy that can help propel some business confidence, some recovery in overall animal spirits, so to say, in the economy. And therefore, I think that would create obviously a headwind and an opportunity to buy at lower level. FIs are getting a little more comfortable about the political risk in India and are overlooking some of the weak economic data short-term and making a bet that things will recover in the next fiscal year. And, you know, may not be a rip-roaring recovery, but at least not as stressed or challenged as the NBFC-led liquidity tightening has caused a lot of economic data to look.
Okay, well, that's the word coming in from Arvind Sanger. Well, we'll go home with the big gains under our belt. The Nifty will go home with that 120-point gain. The Bank Nifty at a new high, and Sensex as well, about 450 points higher. Anuj, you know, before, I mean, we end for the day, just wanted a comment from you. After the kind of minor dip that you've seen, do you get a sense it's perhaps a little late to enter this party, or is it still going to continue?
I think it's obviously a bit late to enter now. I think the best strategy is, if you are in it, to continue. If you're buying fresh, then you need to get hedges in place via the options, puts or whatever. But Sonia, you cannot take away from the fact that it's been a stunning rally.
Yes,
over the last 2 weeks. I think this rally, in a sense, it started with the mid caps. That was the good part. It was not one of those rallies which was narrow and then fizzled out. This rally started with mid caps. So if mid caps are cooling off, no harm in that. From the low point, I think the index is up 13% in less than a month or so. That's good news, I think.
Okay, Deven, before the markets close, you did mention some of the stocks you're bullish on. But within the auto space, is there anything that you would buy? I mean, Eicher Motors is still up almost 13% this month.
Sonia, the preference stays with Ashok Leland for now. It has recovered from the lows, but I believe that I think headroom is quite strong. Probably at this point of time, the opportunity is quite big. You have the scrappage policy, you have the new vehicle demand coming because of the BS6. You have the new vehicle demand coming because more vehicles flying on the road due to GST. And also the availability of credit at lower price, I think, which means that I think the commercial vehicle segment should be in for, I think, good time. So from that perspective, if you look at it, a zero debt company almost, I think Ashok Leyland remains a favorable bet into the portfolio. Stock has corrected from the highs and I think is available at a probably discounted valuation. So I think that gives me the confidence for the higher upside in this particular stock in the auto space.
Okay, fair enough. Let's just recap the day. It's been a stunning day once again, though today was essentially about large caps, not as much mid caps. Today was about the big stocks. ICICI Bank up 3.5%, Larsen & Toubro up 3%, Bharti Airtel up 5%. IndusInd Bank, though it cooled off towards the end, it's not ending at the highest point. 3% higher on IndusInd Bank. Reliance, HDFC Bank, these were a couple of other names where you saw some move. HDFC was higher, Axis Bank, that's a fresh all-time high for Axis Bank. On the way down, Eicher Motors corrected. That was interesting. Let's pull out that stock. 3% down on Eicher Motors by the end. Bajaj Finance was down, and Bharti Infratel, where perhaps now you have some kind of reference in terms of near-term pricing. That stock was also a bit soft. Sonia, index in the mid cap index was underperforming, but still there were big gainers today.
There were big gainers, but I just want to point out that by the end the mid cap index came off quite a bit.
Yeah.
I mean, it paled in comparison to the frontliners. It's up just 0.2%, and the market breadth. When we started the day, it was almost 8-1 in favor of advances. It ends with just 2-1, so it's come off quite a bit. I want to start with the losers just to put a little caution on board. Allahabad Bank, HDFC Life, DHFL, Suzlon Energy. So although this may look like an uptrending market, it's better to be a bit cautious about the stocks that you pick. All the PSU banks have closed in the red. So PNB, Bank of Baroda, even names like Federal Bank, etc., all are in the red. Then you have these vulnerable NBFC stocks like DHFL, etc., that are in the red. Some metal names are in the red, JSPL, etc., closed with losses. And power names like Reliance Power, all the ADAG group stocks, Reliance Communication in the red. You'd have to perhaps be a bit more stock specific in this market. On the upside though, you had real estate stocks that did well. DLF was up in the green. You had JP Associates, not too bad, a trading pop there. Nalco was up about 0.5%. Arvind did well. Some of the non-index large cap stocks like Escorts had a pretty strong showing. So that stock, I think, goes home with about an 8% gain, if I'm not wrong. It should come up for you, 7.5% there. Adani Enterprises, Ajanta Pharma, Fortis Healthcare, etc. were good. But otherwise, Anuj, the mid-caps make you feel a little uncomfortable about the move because there are a lot of stocks, especially the vulnerable names, you know, PSU banks, power stocks, etc. that closed in the red.
I think there are few pockets, PSU banks, for example, few pockets where you got the indication. But the rally has been just stunning. You know, the PSU bank, I think that's led the mid-cap rally. The Nifty PSU Bank Index. That's, of course, today's chart. But if you pull out a one-month chart of the Nifty PSU Bank, just pull out the one-month chart of Nifty PSU Bank. That's today, of course. Look at that move on the one-month. It's been quite big. So, it's okay, Sonia. Just 2 days of back-to-back rally. The focus is, again, coming back to large caps. My only fear is that with the kind of ETF money which is driving this market, the hot money.
Mm-hmm. It could reverse anytime?
No. That, of course, will happen. But, it might end up creating some kind of, trap for a lot of retail in some of the poor names. So poor quality stocks will also rally, because of this rally. And that is where you have to be cautious on. You're okay with, if you're buying on top also, the names like HDFC Twins. But you're not okay buying some of the B group and C group stocks, especially if the market reverses.
Okay, well, on that note, we're going to thank our guests for joining us. It's been a really strong day for the bulls. The Bank Nifty is at a record high. The Nifty is very close to its all-time highs and goes home with a gain of over 1%. Let's